pills or injections. Why do we pick the needle? Parenteral as our route of a drug administration. In just a few minutes, you'll understand exactly when and why injections are the go-to choice. Let's go over the key situations where injections are essential. First, in case the drug is poorly absorbed through mucous membranes. In order for the drug to be absorbed, it should be able to cross the cellular plasma membrane. And when it's unable to cross the membrane, for multiple reasons, one of which is its polarity, we describe it as poorly absorbed drug or a drug with low bioavailability. And injection is the best choice for administration in such cases. The second scenario, when a patient can't take the medication by mouth, like if they are vomiting or the drug itself induces vomiting. In such cases, oral delivery isn't reliable. We might lose the drug through the vomit. Injections become the smarter choice here because they ensure the drug delivery to the bloodstream no matter what. The third scenario, when we need to avoid the first pass effect. In case the drug reached the liver before reaching the bloodstream, we consider this a loss of the drug, since it's going to break down in the liver by metabolism and excreted without being able to actually work. First pass effect, first pass metabolism, pre-systematic metabolism all means the same thing. And if the drug is taken orally, we are definitely losing part of it through this effect, and we do not want this to happen, so we go with injections. The fourth scenario, when we want to avoid uncertainty about how much of the drug gets absorbed. With oral medication, absorption can vary a lot, from person to person, to drug interaction, or even the food content of the stomach. But with injections, we get predictable, reliable drug levels, and with IV specifically, we're delivering 100% of the dose directly into the bloodstream. The fifth scenario, when we need a rapid response. In emergencies like cardiac arrest, severe allergic reactions, we cannot wait for a pill to dissolve and get absorbed. Injections, especially IV, act fast and deliver the drug right where it's needed immediately. The last scenario, when the patient is unconscious. In such cases, swallowing a pill just isn't possible. Injections allow us to give the medication safely and effectively, even when the patient can't take anything by mouth. To get the full picture, we also need to consider the disadvantages of using injections. First, injections can be painful, less convenient for long-term use, especially for patients with needle and anxiety. Second, injections often lead to a faster drug absorption, and while that's useful in emergencies, it can also mean a higher risk of side effects. IV followed by IM show the highest absorption rate and as well the highest risk of side effects. Third, they require proper technique and sterile equipment, meaning we usually need a trained healthcare professional to give them, with strict sterile packaging and handling instructions. Alright, now that you know when and why we use injection, let's see how much actually clicked. Here's a quick quiz to test your understanding. Question number 1. Which of the following is the most appropriate reason to choose an injection over an oral route? A, B, C, or D? Question number 2. Why is intravenous injection the preferred route in emergency situations? A, B, C, or D? If you learned something cool today, smash that like button and hit subscribe for more bite-sized medical lessons. Drop your answers and questions in the comments. Until next time, stay curious.